If you want to realize, to attain Nirvana or to realize Nirvana, then you must practice Noble Eightfold Path. Among the Noble Eightfold Path, number one is Samadhi. What is Samadhi? Yankho Bhikkhu Dukkhe Jnana Dukkha Samudaya Jnana Dukkha Nirodha Jnana Dukkha Nirodha Gaminiya Paripadaya Jnana Yauddhi Bhikkhu Samadhi. In this way, Buddha explained in Mahasatipatthana Sutta. For realization of Four Noble Truths, this you must practice samadhi to fulfill samadhi. For realization of Four Noble Truths, you should have enough concentration. That concentration must practice based on the purification of Vajju. Number two is Samavacha, right speech. Samagamanda, right action. Samajiva, right livelihood. This is the training of morality, Sila Sikha. Based on purification of Sila, you must practice Samadhi, Samavayama, right effort, Samasadhi, right mindfulness. Samasamadhi, right concentration. These three are training of concentration, Samadhi Sikha. Based on purification of Vajju, you must practice the training of Samadhi, especially for purification of Chaitya. Chaitya Visuddhi, you must practice one of Samatha meditation objects. If you can try many Samatha meditation objects, it is better. Now, Dzogchen also may teach you Anapana meditation. Only based on the Anapana meditation, if you want to practice other Samatha meditations, it is also possible. If you want to practice Anapana meditation on this point, no skill, you can pay attention only just in-breath and out-breath, only on the touching point. Don't pay attention to any other object, just only breath object. If you can concentrate for about 10 minutes, this is a very good opportunity. Then, based on that concentration, again, you should increase to another long breath and short breath. Long breath means if you breathe slowly, it is called slow breath, it is called long breath. If you breathe quickly, it is called short breath. Additionally, you should not try to make long or to make short. When it is long, you should try to understand the whole breath from the beginning to the end. When it begins on the touching point only, only the touching point. Except touching point, you should not be addition any other object. Don't follow inside the nose field. Only on the touching point, you should wait and see only just breath. Long breath and short breath, and the whole breath of long breath, the whole breath body of short breath. Except breath, don't be addition to any other object. Don't follow inside the nose field or outside the nose field. On the touching point, on the nose field only, you should pay attention just breath. Please concentrate. If you can concentrate well, then naturally, because of the concentration, the breath will become subtle. If it is not subtle, then you should decide, my breath must become subtle. And then the unsubtle breath, again, you should try to analyze low subtle breath. Short sadhala breath. If you can concentrate well on long sadhala breath, short sadhala breath, then again you should try to anasara the whole breath body of long sadhala breath, the whole breath body of short sadhala breath, whether it is in breath or out breath, both you must try to anasara the whole breath. If you concentrate on the whole breath, the whole subtle breath, long breath and short breath, more than 1 hour, etc., other than usually nimitta will come. But the problem is for many meditators who had practiced before anapana, then based on the light of wisdom around this area will appear. Don't pay attention to the light of wisdom very quickly. If you focus on the light of wisdom outside the nose, very soon the light of wisdom will disappear. You cannot attain jhana quickly. Don't pay attention to the light of wisdom outside the nose field, on the upper lip, etc. Please continue to focus only just long subtle breath and short subtle breath and the whole breath body over long and short subtle breath. If you can concentrate well, when concentration improves about 1 hour, 2 hours, etc., other than naturally, the breath will become nimitta. Nimitta is for beginners, gray smoky gala nimitta. That gray smoky gala nimitta is called prigama nimitta. What is the nimitta? Nimitta is the cause of concentration, jhana concentration for attainment of jhana. Gray smoky gala nimitta is called prigama nimitta, preliminary sign. But don't pay attention to the nimitta very quickly. If you focus on the nimitta, very soon this nimitta will disappear. Because of this, just stay with breath, subtle breath, the whole long subtle breath, the whole short subtle breath body. Don't focus to the nimitta very quickly. When concentrated on the subtle breath object, slowly when concentration improves, the nimitta and subtle breath will begin together. Unification of the breath and nimitta will appear. At that time, also don't pay attention to the nimitta, just stay with breath. While focusing on breath object, slowly when concentration improves, the breath and nimitta become one. Because of this reason, while focusing on the breath object, automatically mind will stick to the nimitta. And then only you can focus on the gray smoky gala nimitta. While focusing on the gray smoky gala nimitta, then if you can concentrate more than 1 hour, 2 hours, etc., because of concentration, the gray smoky gala nimitta will change into white cotton wool gala nimitta. White cotton wool gala nimitta is called Ogaha nimitta, learning sign. At that time, mind automatically will stick to the nimitta. At that time, you can concentrate on the gray, white cotton wool gala nimitta. If you can concentrate more than 1 hour, 2 hours, etc., on that nimitta, then white cotton wool gala nimitta will change into the translucent and bright gala nimitta, like morning star. Translucent and bright nimitta like morning star is called Patibhaga nimitta. That Patibhaga nimitta is must unify with breath. This breath nimitta is called Patibhaga nimitta, counterpart sign. That Patibhaga nimitta is the object of with jhana concentration. The breath and nimitta unify together and at that time, one focus say, on the breath object, mind automatically will stick to the translucent and bright kala nimitta, paribhaga nimitta. That paribhaga, if you can concentrate on that paribhaga nimitta more than 1 hour, 2 hours, etc. At that time, when concentration improves, mind automatically will absorb inside the translucent and bright paribhaga nimitta. That full absorption is called jhana concentration. Whether this is jhana concentration or not, if you want to know, please pay attention inside your heart. other than inside your heart, there is translucent and bright color Bhunga Mindo. And that Bhunga Mindo is like mirror. And that Bhunga Mindo, translucent and bright color Nimaida, Adibhaga Nimaida also will appear. At that time, you get the same five jhana pedas, which arise depending on heart base. Vidyaga, vichara, bidhi, sukha, ekagada. Vidyaga is application of the mind to the translucent and bright nimitta. Vichara is sustainment to the translucent and bright kala nimitta. Bidhi is joy. Sukha is happiness. Ekagada is one-pointedness. These jhana pedas you must discern one by one. But for beginners, Visuddhi Magga suggests not to discern jhana pedas frequently. If you discern frequently, jhana pedas will begin cross. Because of this jhana pedas begin cross, your jhana will fall down very quickly. So for beginners, you must try to do full absorption for a long time. Don't discern jhana pedas frequently. Full absorption also you must try again and again. While concentrated, full absorption concentration, then slowly mind will begin used to see nimitta and to stay inside nimitta. That full absorption, you should try to maintain more than 2 hours, 3 hours, etc. While practicing full absorption stage, more than 2 or 3 hours, etc. At that time, Paijana Pedas also will become clear, and at that time, you should try Paimastari again. Whenever you want to enter into jhana, you must try to enter into jhana. Whenever you want to emerge from jhana, then you can try to emerge from jhana. If you want to do dhyana 1 hour, concentrate full absorption, 1 hour must be, you must pay attention to the Patibhaga Nimitta. You must try to enter into jhana for 1 hour. If you want to enter into jhana for about 2 hours, you should try 2 hours, 3 hours, etc. Then, whenever you want to emerge from jhana, you should try to emerge from jhana. What is the reason? The reason is when practicing vipassana, you must enter into jhana, emerging from jhana, you must contemplate these jhana dhammas as nature, dukkha, and anatta. But if you can stay inside into jhana for a long time, but cannot emerge from jhana quickly, you cannot contemplate vipassana jhana dhammas as nature, dukkha, or anatta. Because of this, you must practice five mastery. If five mantras is okay, then again you can go to second jhana. In second jhana also you must try to practice five mantras. Then you can go on to abhidhuta jhana. That jhana also you must try to practice five mantras. After that you can go to abhidhuta fourth jhana. If you can practice five mantras in fourth jhana, at that time, if you want to change other samatha meditation subjects, it is very easy. If you want to go to vipassana also, you must practice four elements meditation systematically. At that time also, it will be very easy. Because of the supporting cause of fourth jhana concentration. Concentrated mind can understand four noble truths very clearly. At that time, you can practice vipassana systematically. If you want to Fridays more and more, then please try to go to in Ulu Mimu Myanmar.
Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.